Now today we're going to talk about gerbil care. In case you guys don't know, I adopted two gerbils, and they are Anakin and Gordon. And they're in there sleeping right now, but not for long. And I adopted them from a friend that was moving, and I got a nice little instruction sheet. But today we're going to talk about additional measures for caring for your gerbils. And one of the most important things, and what we're first going to discuss, is making sure you have a clean cage. This one here, it had fresh bedding in it when I got it. There they go. That one is, that's Gordon. That was Anakin. Alright, but, we obviously had them for about a week now. And they have little play huts and stuff. They like to chew. They love chewing. And, so they got all kinds of paper chewed up in there. And, but we're going to clean that all out. One thing I did want to mention before we go any further, over here, buried, is their food dish, which they really don't like me touching. But, you'll see they have a porcelain food dish, okay? And they sell plastic ones in the store, but it's very important you don't give your gerbil plastic stuff. They like to chew, as you can see by that box. If you put anything plastic in there, they're going to chew on that too. Alright, but, they sell things like these at different stores, and that's a plastic car for your hamster to go in. Now, they show a gerbil on there, but, you know, there's no recommendations anywhere on this box. Use with supervision. But if you do have something like this, make sure you supervise your animal, and because you don't want anything to happen to them. And what they'll do is they'll chew that plastic up in the little tiny pieces, and they'll choke on them. So, you don't want that to happen. You almost ready, guys? It's bath time. Did I say bath time? Yes, I did. Whenever you're cleaning out your animal's cage, it's also a good time to give them a bath. Well, we got some bath cubes here. Oh, wait a minute. No, we don't want that. We're going to use this. And this is improved for chinchillas, but it's volcanic sand, basically. It's volcanic ash sand stuff. And, even though it says chinchillas on it, your mice and gerbils and everybody, they're going to love that. So I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to actually use my dish that came with my moon sand. And I'm going to dump some of this into there. And then I'm going to put it down in this fairway container so that they can't make too much of a crazy mess with it. And that's where I'm going to transfer them while I'm cleaning out the cage. And to do that, I'm going to use another sterilite container, and I lined it with a plastic bag so I can just dump the aquarium out. Well, the trick's going to be, how do I get them from in there to in there? They don't really like me yet. They won't let me pick them up. I try. They let me put them. But if I try to pick them up, they'll bite me. So I'm not even going to attempt to try to pick them up. So what we're going to do, we're going to use a cupcake box. And some broccoli. So I'm going to lure them into the cupcake box with a piece of broccoli. And then I'm going to close the flap, and then I'm going to tilt it back up, and I'm going to transport them right just like that. Ready? Are we ready, guys? We're all going to go for a little ride. Come on, look. Is it broccoli? Yeah, there you go. No, stay in there. I need the broccoli though. Now it's your turn. There you go. Hop in there. Whoa. And there they go. All ready for bath time. Now they'll just start digging in there, and as soon as they're done worrying about trying to find a way out, they'll start digging in there, and they get themselves all dusted off. And that just scrapes, you know, knocks off any debris from the fur and any oils. and gives them a nice clean coat. They'll start digging in there. All right, now I'm leaving it up to you guys to keep an eye on them, okay? And I just went ahead and stuck a box fan over top there so that we'll limit the chance of any escapees. But here we go. I'm going to dump this thing out. Everything's loose. I'm just going to go ahead and use a little dustpan. Voila. Alright, next we're going to go ahead and just give that a gentle rinse. And we got some mild dish detergent and some rag. And we're going to scrub it up. Okay, so I used my rags, and I just went ahead and scrubbed it like that. I didn't put any actual, you know, I didn't squirt the soap right in here, so it'll be easier to rinse out. But I just scrubbed around all the edges, and we should be good to go. We're going to rinse it all out. Okay, next we're just going to use a whole bunch of paper towels, and we're going to dry it up.